Thank you for tuning into our seller interview series. Up today, we've got an Amazon FBA business for sale in the home niche. Created in March of 2016, this business makes $20,400 per month in net profit. The listing number for the business is 44575. We do these interviews to give potential buyers more information about both the seller and the businesses they're looking to purchase. We hope these insights are helpful for you in making a buying decision. We've got the seller with us today to go through the business and cover everything from niche selection to traffic and monetization. Tyler, thank you for coming on here today. How are you doing?
Hey, Jake. I'm doing pretty well. How about yourself?
Doing excellent. Thank you very much for taking the time to get on to talk about your business. Before we get to the questions that I have for you, I'd like to take a minute and run through a little quick summary of the business. Again, it was built in March of 2016, has a monthly revenue of $80,959, expenses of $60,559 to make for net profit of $20,400, which is generated on a 12-month average. Included in the sale of this business are 19 SKUs, the domain and all site content and files, Facebook account, and trademark. Please note that inventory is not normally included in the list price. Further details can be provided to active depositors. Tyler, can you tell us a little bit about your background in building and running online businesses?
Sure, yeah. Actually, my background is in information technology, and I've always had little side jobs here or there, doing things like building Amazon affiliates, websites, flipping products on eBay, etc. And then I discovered FBA and how much more of a scalable and easy process that is compared to selling items on eBay. And things just kind of progressed over the years. I got into selling private label about 3-4 years ago, and now I've built, or I'm currently building out, 4 brands on Amazon, and that's my full-time job now.
So since you're doing Amazon full-time, this being an Amazon business, why have you decided to sell it today?
Well, I'm selling this business because I want to diversify my income. Right now, 100% of my income is from these 4 FBA brands. And I like to branch out a little and hopefully get into real estate.
So looking at this business over the last 12 months, something you notice is that while you've had an exceptional spring, you know, last fall down to the winter, and then even in February, you had a negative month here in terms of profit. Is this a seasonal business?
Yes, this is a seasonal business. The majority of sales come in the spring and the summer. Mm-hmm. And then, yeah, like you noticed, through the winter, there will be a dip in sales. The products still sell. Mm-hmm. It's just much slower in the off season. And then the reason for the dip in February is basically the month before the season comes on. And that's when we like to do product launches or, you know, relaunching existing products to get them up on page 1 if they aren't already. So that way all of our products are positioned well for March when the mm-hmm. season comes on, and then the sales come in organically.
Yeah, and something you notice, you know, looking at February is the profit was down, but the revenue was up compared to January. So like you mentioned, you must have just been investing and pushing ads and such, trying to rank the products for the season.
That's correct, yep.
So when you look at this business as it currently stands, what does it take from you, the owner, to maintain it?
Right now, I spend probably 5 to 10 hours a week running this business. I do some customer service, reordering of the products. I spend time on things like order forecasting and managing stock levels, which is fairly important for a seasonal business. I also do things like evaluating new products to launch. We've got great relationships with all of our suppliers. They're always sending us new products all the time to test. One other thing I do, I spend a little time managing PPC with a software tool, but that doesn't take too much time, as we only really run sponsored ads on just a handful of the products. I like to focus more on ranking keywords and getting organic sales versus spending on ads.
Do you have any employees who help you run this business, or are you the only one working on it?
I'm the only one working on it.
So can you explain your presence outside of Amazon?
We also sell on Walmart, but other than that, we don't really have a presence outside of Amazon. I mean, we own the domain names, we have social media accounts, but they're really not used at all.
I know you have the trademark and the Amazon Brand Registry 2.0. Are the domain and the social media, was that primarily for brand presence on the web to register for the brand registry?
That's correct, yep.
So if you're going to continue to own this business and try to grow it even more, what are the major opportunities for growth that you would focus on?
Sure, yeah, that's a good question. There's a few different things that you could do to grow this business. First, I would say expanding into other Amazon markets. Amazon is getting quite large in a number of different countries around the world. Another thing you could do is, well, all of our products they're strongly related and branded well, so you could set up a Shopify store and drive traffic to that to get another source of revenue outside of Amazon. And thirdly, and I think most importantly, is just adding new SKUs from existing suppliers to grow the revenue. In fact, I've got a few new product samples sitting here that I just received, and depending on the timing of a deal, I'll either be launching those soon myself, or I could help a buyer launch those products and walk them through that process.
You mentioned selling on a Shopify site, for example, or expanding to the other Amazon markets. Is there a reason why you haven't already pursued that yourself?
Yeah, it's basically just a time thing. I haven't taken the time to invest into that sort of thing. Like I mentioned before, I'm actually running four different Amazon brands right now. And the place to be is, for the most part, is Amazon, because they provide the customers, and outside traffic isn't really one of my skill sets either.
Do you feel like there are any potential risks associated with this business that a new owner should be aware of?
That's a good question. Yeah, there's obviously risks with any business. This business specifically, since it's on Amazon, there's a risk of selling on Amazon, from suspensions to listings being taken down, hijackers, that sort of thing. You know, we've always operated 100% by the rules and the terms of service, and we've never really run into any big issues. Like, I've been on Amazon for over 7 years, never been suspended or anything like that. But one positive thing I would say is that our revenue is fairly well spread out across our product line. So if you do have an ASIN go down for a week or a few days, it doesn't hurt the revenue in a big way, because all the other products share the revenue well.
Seeing as you've been as successful as you have been with the Amazon platform, and you're running four brands right now, if someone came to you and said, "Hey, Tyler, I want to get started with my own Amazon brand and wanted your advice," what would be the number one thing that you would tell them?
Yeah, the number one thing that I always tell people is to focus on launching products that are at least somewhat unique in the marketplace. It just makes every step of the process so much easier, as you aren't fighting against a sea of copycat products. And that's something that we've always tried to do with this brand and all of my brands, is just to put out unique products. It just, like I said, it just makes the process so much easier.
Would you commit to a non-compete?
Yes, certainly. I would still continue to be selling on Amazon, but we would stay completely away from this niche, yeah.
How much support are you willing to provide a new owner during the transition period?
Really, I'll offer as much support as the buyer needs to run the business and grow it, whether that's 30 days or even a few months. Ideally, I'd help the new owner kind of navigate through the next season and help them with figuring out stock levels they'll need, preseason launches, things like that. I could even create custom SOPs if needed as well.
Are you open to negotiating on something like an earnout, where perhaps a percentage of the proceeds from the sale would be paid out in the coming months rather than all of it up at front?
Yeah, I would be open to that.
Tyler, thank you very much for taking the time with me today. Before I let you go, I have one final question. If you were looking at this business from the perspective of a potential buyer, why would you feel like it is an asset worth buying?
Well, I think this business is valuable because it's well-aged, with over 3 years of placement on Amazon, and cumulatively we have thousands of organic reviews. And like I mentioned earlier, a lot of the products we've done are unique in some way, which gives you an advantage over all the other copycat products out there. I think another positive is the fact that so many of the different products do well that it really spreads your risk out. We don't have like just two products doing 90% of the revenue or anything like that. And we have such great relationships with our factories. You know, they're always giving us tips on new products that they're developing, or products that they think will fit well in our niche. And we have multiple factories that operate in the same niche, and they all can make the same products. So if you happen to lose one supplier for some reason, the others can still make the products for you. So that really lowers your risk as well.
Thank you very much for taking the time with me today. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, you bet. It was a pleasure being on.
If you're watching this on YouTube, subscribe to our channel. And if you want more information, the link will be below the video that will take you to this marketplace listing. If you're watching this on the listing page and want more information, become a depositor today. When you make the deposit, one of our business advisors will be in contact with you, and you will be given everything you need to review this business. Have a great day.